mentioned North London and Highbury, and obviously your love for the Arsenal. And
oh yeah,
what is it? Just because? Why didn't you go to Spurs? What happened there? You got to say that.
Don't be daft.
You could never have gone to Spurs.
No, and my dad would make sure of that anyway.
So he was an Arsenal man as well.
Yeah, he took us there at four, and just fell in love with the place, and you know the pageantry of it all, and that's a good thing. Support your local.
What about
always support your local? If I came from Tottenham, I'd be Tottenham.
Yeah,
I don't resent them for being Tottenham.
There's people who come from like in and around where you were and who supported Tottenham.
Well, there's a whole bunch now. I mean, people come down regularly. Say, from even Coventry, they're Arsenal now.
But, yeah,
you know, it's a different thing with me. And that working class ethic, I suppose, it was support your local.
Did you get to, because like obviously doing the band and getting involved with a band, and how did you combine the both of them? Did you actually get to see games? Because I would have thought
I started touring, you know, no, not so much. And I haven't been to the new ground at all yet.
You've not been to the
other? No, I'm a season ticket holder, but I give the tickets to my brother's kids.
So when you're over now, how long you been over there?
I'm going to be there on Saturday.
You're going to the car?
Sunday,
yeah.
Well, actually, Saturday I will start drinking.
Who are you going with?
And anything that will keep me awake all night.
Who are you going with? You going?
Rambo.
Rambo, you're an Arsenal man as well?
Yeah, we're going with the proper herd. Proper herd.
Yeah. It's a good...
You know, and we're in with the proper peoples, not up there in the celeb box.
And the prawn sandwiches, yeah.
Will you be there?
I won't be there, because to be honest, I'd rather watch on the box. I just like watching it on the box now. And you know, I don't like, I don't want to go there and mix with the people, you know what I mean?
You can get pestered.
It's a nightmare.
Yeah.
You know, by the time you get there, you know, even to watch the game, I got tickets to the Barcelona game. And I gave my tickets away because I watched it at home.
Yeah.
Because you go there and it turns into a, can you come over here and do this for
this
corporate box? Can
no,
you do
yeah,
it?
No,
you...
you're not giving 5 seconds. And it can get like
do you get,
that.
Do you get, does it get like that for you as well when people see it? Can you get a little bit on top for you?
No, I just put my drunk face on and they stay well away.
What about being
I haven't been in a long while. So for me, you know, the final is going to be kind of hilarious because let's face it, Arsenal haven't been really, you know, collecting the trophies now for quite some time.
Yeah.
But then again, you know, I hardly think they're going to do it on Sunday either.
Why not?
After that Leighton Orient game.
No. I think that off of the Barcelona game, John, it was, I think...
I'm worried about who he'll put in the goal. I really am. If it's Fat Mattress and Aluminium, we're doomed.
To be honest, I've not got no confidence in Fabianski or Almunia. You can see now, because I think... No. Chesney will be in goal.
Yeah, oh, he's great.
I think that Wenger now, what he's going to do, John, is that we need to get the Carling Cup because... No. I think that... What's his name? Koscielny and Giroud are good enough for the Birmingham game. Whether they're going to be good enough in the Barcelona way is a different thing, but we need to win this competition only because it gives... There's a lot of... People don't understand with this Arsenal team, John, is that there's a lot of the players ain't won anything.
Yeah.
They don't even know what it's like to win anything.
Yeah.
And winning becomes an habit. If they win this, people talking about the quadruple. Step. Exactly. Right. Now, this is such an important game.
We had a nice game of footy.
I'm actually tired of hearing people say how well Arsenal are playing. You know, 5 years, they haven't won anything.
Well, you listen, I'm so pleased to hear you say those two goalkeepers. Yeah,
they
are a nightmare.
Between
them,
they ain't a goalie.
Really,
between
really them. Hopeless, terrible. But then again, there's been some real... poor rear gunners back there. in the defence.
Yeah. Well, I think that what happened, John, is that they played...
Whose names I can't even pronounce.
Scolacci and
that's
Scolacci,
the one.
Yeah, and Koscielny. They meant to come in.
He sounds like a skin disease.
They were meant to come in to play with Vermaelen.
Yeah.
And because he's brilliant.
Yes, John. He is.
You know, he's brilliant.
He's brilliantly unavailable.
At the moment, yeah. But what about LA? You're in LA at the minute. Do you get to go across to see Bex at the Galaxy, would you?
No, I wouldn't.
You wouldn't?
The slightest bit of interest in that. That's all showbiz and flogging T-shirts.
You think so?
Yeah. Beckham was all right in his day. Nothing wrong with the lad, but the fella. You know, he seems pleasant enough, but, you know, it's not for me.
It's not for you, no. It's not real. It doesn't feel like real football.
No, it don't. There's no relationship I have with that, you know. I know Beckham trained with Arsenal, but then he wanted to go to Tottenham.
Well, I think
that's telling you.
Well, it's one of those because while he's out there, he can actually you know.
I know it's a bet.
So yeah, but like the thing is, once he did train with Arsenal and then he went to train with Tottenham, it seems a bit weird.
It does, doesn't it?
You know what I mean?
But then again, all them fellas seem to be mates.
Yeah.